guess let's get down to it. Tonight's first performer, please welcome Tony Jordan.
Okay, how's everybody doing? Okay, greet the audience. So a thing that people in our little group tend to like to talk about is their ADHD, which is great, because last year it was Tinder, and nobody messaged me on Tinder, but I have ADHD, I can talk about this. Where are you? I like you. Beautiful. Oh yeah, I live with you. Great. You park the car?
Yeah.
Great. Okay. Yes, I have ADHD. And ADHD is a wonderful thing. It comes in like a whole bunch of different flavors with extra letters and stuff. And mine is called ADHD PI. And that is the boring one. Yeah, I'm not running around with the boundless energy and running up and saying impulsive things to people, asking people to be the love of my life. No, all I get is the, okay, we're in a world history one, and he's talking about Babylon or some shit. And there's the window, and out we go. There's birds. I wonder what birds think. Let's think about what birds think. That was a good thought. And now we're back into 2 hours. 2 hours we thought about this. What is this? Is that math? Is that math? Where am I? What is this? Who are you? It's like, the only way I can think to properly describe what this is like is that my brain is practicing for Alzheimer's. It's like, it's setting it up so that when I get Alzheimer's, nobody has to treat me any differently than they were before. I can just stand around and go, he never knew what was going on and forgot things all the time, and now he just doesn't know who we are. That's just one more thing we have to explain. We'll put it on the chart. Like a great example of this is, I'm in another group. It's a sketch group. It's called In Memoriam. Plug. I'm in a sketch. I was in a sketch. I have one main speaking role in a sketch. I'm important. And I helped plan a rehearsal Sunday, 8 p.m. Sunday at 8 p.m. rolls around, and I'm at my parents' house having dinner. And I get like this feeling in my brain, like, you need to leave. Like, you need to go. And I'm like, this food's free. Why would I leave free food at any point? And I get a text from the other guy I'm playing the rehearsal with, and he goes, hey, so where are we meeting in the hub? And I had no idea what the fuck he was talking about. Like, I'm at dinner right now, away from here. Why is anyone at the hub? Why are you at the hub? And so the next day happens, and it's about midnight, and he posts in the group's Facebook, if you have a script for the sketch, put a script for the sketch up so people can rehearse their lines. That's what he sounds like. I looked at that, and I go, oh yeah, I'm in a sketch. I'm in a sketch, I should look at that. Rehearsal Sunday at 8 p.m. Sunday at 8 p.m. this week. That was yesterday. What the fuck?! Like, how does this happen? Like, ADHD explains things like that. It explains my whole life, my entire childhood, in that I've forgotten most of it. I looked it up and it's like, is it normal? And this guy was like, is it normal to forget your whole childhood? And it's like, yeah, no, I pretty much have spotty memory up until I was 11.
Yeah, that's weird, isn't it?
Yeah, you usually, the spots that you do remember, the spotty bits, are the shit bits. You only remember the shit bits. You had a shitty childhood, didn't you? Oh my. We'll talk later. I remember, this is a moment I remember from fifth grade. I remember it is that a friend, a person walked up to me
And I said, hey, we're doing, you know, the project we're doing, we have to write a story. Can I use you in the story? It's about a giant who fights people. And I'm like, yay, being included. Plus, I was a giant. And as you can plainly tell, I never was nor ever will be a giant. So that's fascinating. And story, time comes time to present the stories. And I remember it verbatim. It goes like this. It goes like this. There once was a big giant named Tony, and he lived in Beaver Stadium, as me. And he was the ugliest giant that ever lived. He was so ugly that that is why he lived at Beaver Stadium. None of the other giants wanted him around. That's me. And one day he was getting up and doing his morning routine, and he scratched his stomach, and a piece of mold came out of his belly button and came alive. I look this guy up later. He's in landscaping. It's a tragedy. We lost a great author. And this piece of mold begins to kill and terrorize everyone at State College. And the giant, feeling bad that he's done this, knows he has to do something. And he tried punching it, and it didn't work. And he tried kicking it, and it didn't work. And finally, the giant, that's me, knew that the only thing he could do was lift his arms. And the smell killed it, along with everyone in State College. There's more. As he's lamenting the deaths of everyone he's ever known and watched walk around in State College, another piece of mold comes out. And the only thing he can think to do is body slam it as it tries to body slam him, and they explode. The end. The greatest part about this is that this is not being read by the poet savant that hath wrote it. This is being read aloud to everyone in my whole class by my fifth grade teacher. And she is laughing her ass off to tears. So it's okay, she got cancer. She got better! I am not the monster from the story. No, actually, that was like the fourth or fifth time she'd gotten cancer. So like, she's pulled this shit before. And like, the karmic gods resting on high are like, she's ruined another one. She scarred another child. What do we do? Cancer. Obviously we do cancer. Dude, no, that hasn't worked the last three times we've tried this. Oh, shit. Okay, well, I guess we just have to let her get old and pull some trick to force her retirement, I guess. I don't know. Jeez. That's my five, thank you very much.